गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज आवर थर्ड लेक्चर ऑफ चैप्टर 2, हिस्ट्री, किंग्स, फार्मर्स एंड टाउन। टुडे वी डिस्कस टॉपिक 5, अ चेंजिंग कंट्री साइड एंड टॉपिक 6, टाउन एंड ट्रेड। फॉर दिस डिस्कशन यू हैव टू ओपन पेज नंबर 38 ऑफ योर बुक। टॉपिक 5, अ चेंजिंग कंट्री साइड। दिस टॉपिक स्टार्ट्स विद सब हेडिंग पॉपुलर परसेप्शन ऑफ किंग्स। एंथोलॉजीज सच एज द जातकाज एंड पंचतंत्र गेव अ ग्लिम्स ऑफ सब्जेक्ट किंग रिलेशन। फॉर इंस्टेंस, वन स्टोरी नोन एज गदांतेंदु जातका डिस्क्राइब्स द प्लाइट ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट्स ऑफ अ विग्ड किंग। किंग्स फ्रिक्वेंटली ट्राइड टू फिल देयर कॉफर्स बाय डिमांडिंग हाई टैक्सेस एंड पीजेंट्स पर्टिकुलरली फाउंड सच डिमांड्स ऑप्रेसिव। सर्टेन स्ट्रेटजीज aimed at increasing production to meet growing demand for taxes also were adopted. For example, the shift to plough agriculture, which spread in fertile alluvial river valleys such as those of Ganga and the Kaveri from 6th century BCE. Also, production of paddy was dramatically increased by the introduction of transplantation in agriculture. Another strategy adopted to increase agricultural production was the use of irrigation through wells and tanks and less commonly canals. The benefit of increased production led to a growing differentiation amongst people engaged in agriculture as it was not equally distributed. The stories of Buddhist tradition refers to the term Gahapati, which was often used in Pali text to designate the second and third categories. Tamil literature mentions large landowners or vellar, plugmen or ojhavar, and slaves or adimai. With rising differences, questions of control over land must have become crucial, as these were often discussed in legal text. During early centuries of Common Era, grants of land were made and many of which were recorded in inscriptions. For instance, according to Sanskrit legal text, women were not supposed to have independent access to resources such as land. Land grants provide some insight into the relationship between cultivators and the state. Towns and trade. Major towns were located along routes of communication. Some, such as Pataliputra, were on riverine routes. Some were near the coast from where sea routes began. Many cities like Mathura were bustling center of commercial, cultural and political activities. A wide range of artifacts have been recovered from the excavation in these areas. These include fine pottery, bowls and dishes with a glossy finish known as northern black polished ware, probably used by the rich people, and ornaments, tools, weapons, vessels, figurines made of wide range of material such as gold, silver, copper, bronze, ivory, etc. By the 2nd century BCE, we find short votive inscriptions in a number of cities, sometimes guild or serines, organizations of craft producers and merchants are mentioned as well. From 6th century BCE, land and river routes crisscrossed the subcontinent and extended in various directions. Rulers often attempted to control the routes, possibly by offering protection for a price. Those who transferred these routes included peddlers who probably travelled on foot and merchants who travelled with caravans of bullock carts and pack animals. Spices, especially pepper, were in high demand in the Roman Empire, as were textile and medicinal plants, and these were all transported across the Arabian Sea to the Mediterranean Sea. Exchanges were facilitated by the introduction of coinage. Punched marked coins made of silver and copper were amongst the earliest to be minted and used. Attempts were made to identify the symbols or punch mark coins with specific ruling dynasties. The first coins to bear the names and images of rulers were issued by the Indo-Greeks, who established control over the northwestern part of the subcontinent. The first gold coins were issued by the Kushanas. The widespread use of gold coins indicates the enormous value of the transactions that were taking place. Some of the most spectacular gold coins were issued by the Gupta rulers from 6th century onwards. Hoards of Roman coins have been found from archaeological sites in South India. It is obvious that networks of trade were not confined within political boundaries. South India was not part of the Roman Empire, but there were close connections through trade with Roman Empire. Stay home, stay safe. In fourth lecture, we will discuss some other topics. Bye. Make a nice day. Thank you.